Today we're going to be going over some stippling, and this is what we're going to start off with. Plain Jane Glock 23, 40 cal. As you can see, nothing's been done to it so far. Everything's like, comes out of the factory. This is another Glock 22. This is what it's going to kind of look like when we're done. And I've also done a little bit of work to my holster. I don't know if you can see that. Look at the lighting. I started off with just a release, and then I started messing around and thought I'd put in a design, and it came out okay. Here's something else I've just been kind of playing around with. This is an extra stock that I have for my Bushmaster AR-15. Put in a Punisher skull on this side, stippled in the interior. And as you can see up here, I did it the reverse. And also play with some more tribal designs on this side. Alright. Some of the things we're going to be using today is plain old soldering iron. I got this at Lowe's for like $17 plus tax. Comes with a few different tips. I'm going to start off with this flat tip. And then as you can see, comes with a few more different ones. The reason I'm starting off with this flat tip is because, oh, and by the way, for all you video Nazis out there, when I started this off, I called this the 23. It's obviously not a 23, it's a Glock 22, which is a mid-full frame. So anyways, what I'm going to be doing on this one is I'm going to stipple over this top of the back strap, just the top. I'm going to leave this how it is. And so what you want to do is you want to melt this down and get you a half-decent flat surface to start with. And then we're also going to do the same thing around the finger grips. We're gonna melt these down flat, and then stipple over them, stipple this whole front strap. You wanna make sure your soldering iron is good and hot before you even start. And let me start by this. Here for all you video Nazis, safety check. We're going to go ahead and take the top slide off of the bottom just to make it a little bit lighter, easier to work with. And we're going to start with this part right back here. And I'll go ahead and do a little bit just to show you guys what you're going to be getting into. And I always put down, also, I put down an old cutting mat that my wife let me use, and it seems to work pretty good just to protect the table and all that good stuff. So when you start this, you just want to go light, get it going, because it's not going to melt down immediately. Just kind of want to start getting those top edges off. And the more you do it, the hotter the whole frame will get. So if you're doing the whole back strap, I would suggest to do a little bit. Let it cool down, do a little bit, because this polymer retains heat pretty good. Oops, I went down a little too low right there. That's another thing, you gotta be super careful because there's no going back with this. Once you get it, once you start it, that's it. So this isn't a temporary mod. Once you do this, this is what you're stuck with. But if you do it right, or at least half decent, you should be pretty happy with the results, and you wouldn't want to change it back anyways. And I'm not applying that much pressure either. Kind of just letting it float on the top a little bit. So I'll go ahead and finish this, and then we'll pick up where we left off. As you can see, I've already went over all of it with the flat tip, melted it all down. Then I took a 100 grit sandpaper, just took off the rough edges, and then I took a 80 grit and went over it again. I went ahead and I marked off, give me a rough estimate of where I'm going to be going around, what I'm going to be going around. I'm going to be putting a diamond down here. Same thing on this side. Pencil seems to work pretty good. We've switched to this tip, which is just the regular round one. So here's the same Glock that we started off in the beginning of this video, tutorial, whatever. And just gonna go over it again so you guys can see it. On this one, I even did the trigger a little bit. If you decide to do that, be really, really careful. This plastic, it melts a little bit faster than the rest of the polymer. I didn't do the side panels on this one. Kind of haven't decided what I'm going to do. Might put some kind of design in there or something, I don't know. So I left the side panels at the bottom. Bottom of the back strap. And here is the final product on the Glock that didn't have anything done to it. This is all after everything said and done. I did everything on this one. The whole front strap. On this side, we left the Glock just because it kind of looks cool. I left about half of the back strap, the original back strap. Took me about 3 or 4 hours to do this whole thing. after melting everything down and then bringing it back to life. Came out pretty good. This is my third Glock that I've done with the stippling. And I dig it. Thank you for watching. This video is brought to you by JH Customs.